In this we're revealing how to become a freelance writer and how complete beginners earning $100 to even $700 a day with no experience. More of that after the intro. Hey guys, how's it going? Mike Facile here. Welcome to this video. Before we actually begin, remind you that several spots have opened up for this week's free workshop, where it's the fastest and easiest way to make money online. We literally have a 62-year-old woman go from zero to 160 grand profit in 90 days, so sign up for it now. So here's a very interesting thing. I live here in Bali, Indonesia, and not only here in Bali, Indonesia, are there all these like really successful people that I interview on my podcast, like this 11-year-old girl that turned on $30 million, this guy that makes $1 million per month, right? But there's also a lot of people that make a bunch of money as just freelance writers that literally write when they want to, how much they want to, and literally just travel around the world. And it blows my mind because so many people are like, oh, to become successful and to have freedom, to be my own boss, I need to start my own company and my own business, and I have to hire a team. But little do you know that there's actually a lot of people that are freelance writers that literally go ahead and make a full-time living just by writing and doing it and writing about the things that they love. And if you're someone that's like that and you wanna find a way to start making $100 a day to even $700 a day and more, then this is exactly what I would do if I were you. The first step is really defining what do you want to write about and why. Now, here's the thing, you know, so many people when they first get started and wanting to learn how to just make money in general, they are just so in a scarcity mindset that they're like, oh, I will do literally anything for whatever dollar costs and whatever, right? And they don't actually define what it is that they actually wanted. Like when I first started writing online, I knew that on my blog and my website where I do like most of my writing before we even started scaling it, is I knew I was gonna talk about, okay, I wanna talk about and write about finances, passive income, ways to generate money online. You could actually see, for those that are new to my masterpiece of this blog, let me humbly introduce myself. My name is Mike Facile, and I'm kind of like a mad scientist when it comes to making passive income online. Every single day, I'm always testing, researching, concocting more and more ways to generate multiple passive income streams so that I can survive the next recession, zombie apocalypse, or Illuminati takeover, right? So you can see that I defined this very particularly because if I was gonna go ahead and write for other people, I might as well also start seeing, well, what is my long-term potential, right? Yeah, I could write for other people and maybe get like, for example, up to $100 a day. But to scale, I'm gonna have to get to the point where I can do freelance writing for myself, right? So understanding that, you know, you could see exactly the vision of where you could take it, because maybe you don't always wanna make $100 a day. Maybe you wanna make more. Maybe you start a family. Maybe you start traveling more. Maybe you know, your lifestyle expenses just start going up and you want more out of life. You're gonna have to have that bigger vision of, okay, where do I wanna be 5 or 10 years down the road? And I think the biggest problem for people that want to become freelance writers is to not actually see an end goal of where their content could take them. They're like, oh, you know, this website and this entrepreneur wants me to write about, for example, dog leashes, right? So I'm gonna be the best dog leash article writer in the world. And yeah, you could make good money for the first year, but how many times do you actually wanna talk about, you know, for example, dog leashes, right? It's gonna get very repetitive very fast. You know, for me, I can't stop about learning about finances, investments, I'm learning how to make passive income online. As you can see, just even documenting my journey of going, like, for example, in the past 30 days, we've netted about like $52,000 net. But the craziest thing is in the past 7 days, we've netted about like $2,000 net. But here's the thing, you know, I knew that I could never stop talking about this, right? I knew that I was always interested about it. Defining who you are, what you want to do, and why is one of the most important things when getting started. The second thing is build up a portfolio. Now, if you're gonna go ahead and get hired by clients, they're gonna wanna know, okay, well, before I invest in you, what do you sound like? What do you write like? Do you have any examples, right? Like, for example, now I actually hired some freelance writers to go ahead and write for my blog and my blog articles, and they have like specific messaging and style. Like, for example, this one, I actually did not go ahead and create this blog post, someone else did. But before we actually went and hired them like to be a freelance writer, I wanted to see, well, what did their voice sound like? And can they have the ability to, for example, like, have a voice where I resonate with, where it could literally even like sound like me, so I could even just like outsource my work, right? So literally I would see some of their things and I was like, okay, wow, I like this person's style. I like how they organize everything. You can see that it's a long ass post. teaching people how to make affiliate marketing, for example, with Pinterest and whatnot, right? And that's exactly what I wanted, but you're not gonna hire somebody if you have no idea how they write. You know, that's a risk on the entrepreneur that's hiring you. If you have a portfolio of, okay, these are all the pieces I wrote, it makes you and the ability to sell your service a lot more better. Now, the third step is just sharpening your sword. Now, what do I actually mean by that, okay? Well, you wanna think about your skill set like a sword. And if you don't practice it, your sword will get dull and rust and break. Now, when it comes to, you know, for example, making money as a freelance writer, you get paid for how good you are at the skill. If you suck at writing and you're not getting any clients, odds are you're not gonna become a freelancer unless you get better. And the only way to get better is to put in the work. How do I know that I'm getting better at these videos? Because I make a lot of videos. Some days I'm like really excited and passionate and excited. I'm like, yeah, let's create this content. Today, I feel a little sickly. You know, I literally have like a bunch of toilet paper that I'm blowing my nose on the side. And I'm like, no, I gotta put in the reps today because I know that this is gonna make me better as someone that creates content. And if you're a writer and you're creating content, guess what? You're gonna have to, you know, for example, do days where you love doing it, right? Which is great. Like last week, I loved creating content. Today, I'm just like, oh man, like I don't wanna create this content, but I know that, okay, I set myself the schedule. It's kind of like what Seinfeld did. I don't know if you know who Seinfeld is. It's this guy right here that made this show. It's actually this guy right here, right? If I do Seinfeld, for example, net worth, you could see that this person is actually worth $950 million, Jerry Seinfeld. So you're probably wondering, well, how? And this is exactly what he talked about. Here's like a really interesting image right here. His story was he was like every single day, he was gonna go and put an X every single time he would go ahead and start writing for jokes, right? So he was technically a freelance writer, but he was also pitching those jokes, right? Every single day he would write a joke. Some days it would be hilarious, some days it wouldn't be. His only goal wasn't actually how funny the joke would be, it was that every single day he could put an X to when he actually did, you know, his practice of getting better. And his goal is to make sure that these chains don't start breaking. And that's essentially what it is. Like, for example, for me, I was like, I'm gonna publish every single day. That's really it. I don't care if I'm in really good state of mind or if I feel like crap and I'm blowing my nose out of, like, for example, toilet paper because I don't have any like tissue paper right here. I just know this is what I'm gonna do. But for you, if you wanna get good at freelance writing, you really gotta devote some time to, for example, get good at that skill. Is it every single day? Is it three times a week? If your plan does not exist on a schedule, you're never gonna actually have the time to do it. And the more you sharpen your sword and invest in finding your voice, the better it is for you, which leads me to the fourth step. And that is, don't forget to invest in your own growth. So for example, for me, I'm always getting more education, right? Like for example, I'm getting courses, I'm getting from mentors, I'm going to workshops, I'm going to events. How can I get better at my craft? Okay, because the better I can invest in myself, that's like the best investment, man. Like people are like, oh, I'm gonna invest in Bitcoin or for example, you know, like Amazon and whatnot, and I'm gonna get a 10% return. But you have no idea that when I invest, for example, in myself, I can get 100x return, 1000x return. You know, there's this like one program that taught me, for example, how to like do sales and marketing, right? I think I paid $300 for that program like several years ago. That one program helped me learn some sales and marketing tactics that literally changed my life, right? And I like 100x the amount in that investment. If you do not find a way to invest in yourself and grow your skills, it's gonna be harder for you to level up. And the fifth thing is learning exactly how to sell. I know that sounds weird. Oh, I wanna become a freelance writer. I don't wanna become a salesman. But that's how success is in life. You have to learn how to sell. You have to learn how to sell yourself, right? You know, any single business or company has sales because without sales, there's no revenue. With no revenue, there's no business. And when you wanna become a freelance writer, you gotta ask yourself, okay, well, freelance writing is a service. How can I go ahead and get customers? And clients, I have to learn how to sell them. How do I learn how to sell? I have to define their pain points. For example, I hired somebody to, for example, go ahead and literally write on my blog, right? And he charged me $7,000 for it. They're probably wondering, what? This writer charges you $7,000 for it? Well, it's pretty simple. This person knew how to sell. Not only was he not the one even writing, but he got other people to do the writing for him. And it's because he understood what my pain points were. He was like, okay, we'll write pieces of content for you so you don't have to write them yourself. We'll reach out to other blogs so that we could link those articles to them so that we can build your authority on your website presence. And we'll do all the updating so you don't have to. It'll be completely turnkey. I'm like, whoa. So in my mind, I'm like, okay, if I pay him $7,000 and it makes me
20 grand a month, how many times would I pay them 7 grand? Probably every month that I'm making 20 grand, right? So learning how to sell is very effective, because if you can position your writing and freelance writing and that, oh, we're really gonna create the content for you, we're gonna help you rank on Google, it will literally position you in a way where you are more valuable in the person's eyes, right? So that's the more important thing. Find out what their pain points are. Like, for example, for me, I wanted someone to create the content for me so I don't have to focus on creating content, right? Because maybe in a year or 2 or 5 years, maybe I don't want to create content anymore. Maybe I want to focus on, you know, investing, right? And doing that, I have this horizon where, okay, if I just build my blog and my website and hire freelance writers to go ahead and write on this, I can essentially outsource myself in the next 3 to 5 years. So how much is that worth to me when I can literally buy back 30 to 50 years of my life? So it's extremely valuable, right? Learning how to sell would be the only way to actually start charging for those services. And last but not least thing is you need to learn how to network, man. Networking is the most important thing. Like, so many people think, oh, I have to do this by myself, but you can't grow without networking, especially if you're trying to get clients. And if you're somebody that, you know, is a freelancer, right, you gotta ask yourself, well, where are your clients hanging out with? Are they going to events? Do they hang out on Facebook groups? Do they hang out, you know, for example, in certain cafes here in Bali? You know, I ended up meeting this person at a cafe here in Bali, you know, and because there's so many entrepreneurs here, there's also so much service providers that are here. You got to find out where can you meet them, right? For me, when I was like stuck at home and I couldn't do anything, I literally got people and clients from Facebook groups. Like, there's so many clients where there's a lot of business owners that hang out, like, for example, in Facebook ad groups, in blogging groups, in website groups. Those are a lot of big ones, and you can join them for free, right? And when you start doing that, you start seeing exactly the pain points that people are talking about, but you could come in and sell your service. And that's the most important thing, but you only get to that point if you can network, okay? And networking becomes easier actually when you start creating content for yourself and starting your own website and your blog. But of course, it could take some time, which is why if you want an even faster, there's a way to make money online where we literally have students go from like $10 a day, $100 a day, even $1,000 a day and more. Make sure you sign up for this week's free workshop, because we literally have like the 62-year-old woman go from zero to $160,000 in 90 days. As well, check out my podcast of all these really successful people that live here in Bali that make a bunch of money online. Check it out right here and here. See you guys later. You. We'll be right back.